On today's show, flying food.
Bruschetta's bruschetta. It should be crispy, shouldn't it?
Dodgy DIY.
Got a man cage and he's escaped.
And a gobby guest.
I was like a mouse next to Sam.
As four rival hosts battle it out for a £1,000 prize.
Do sheeps have any gabbers?
This week, we're in and around Cambridge, famous for its punting, which comes from the Dutch word to push.
Careful, sir.
And looking to blow the competition out of the water this week is 34-year-old footy fan and sports events organiser Tom Lee. Shot!
I'm a bit of a mickey taker, so, if I get on a roll, then, God forbid. If there's somebody who drops their guard down, I think I'll be all over them, yeah.
Yeah, that's my job.
Will my food be nice? I just hope I don't poison anyone.
That would probably be for the best.
I'd like to think of myself as being good life number two. I've got my carrots, I've got my veg, I've got the shotgun. So I have everything that I need.
Watch out! Oh, I did warn you. Meet 32-year-old fresh food fanatic Nicole Saunders.
I really have no idea what to expect for tonight. The main thing for me, more than anything, is the food. I want some decent grub.
Well, hopefully Tom's main course will tickle the taste buds. Spicy lamb shanks with couscous.
I went to the Sahara Desert last year, so I've gone for a kind of a Moroccan theme, lots of spices. I like my food really spicy, so I just hope they do as well.
Spicy lamb? I've never experienced spicy lamb before. I just like lamb with mint. I don't know that I'm going to like that very much.
Proving hard to please is 27-year-old estate agent and self-confessed motormouth Sam Friend.
Most people would say that I have a lot to say and I only have one volume. Mother used to always say to me, "You've only got one volume, Samantha. Turn it down. You're too loud and you talk too much."
Earplugs at the ready then, Tom. He starts by marinating his lamb shanks with chilies and spices, then seals the meat.
I can hardly breathe at the moment.
He adds chicken stock and a bottle of red wine. Tom will serve the lamb with couscous, which he'll cook later.
Couscous.
What's funny about that?
It's a ridiculous name, isn't it?
You don't say rice, do you?
Well, you may have a point there, actually. Rounding off our quartet is 61-year-old retired hairdresser and all-round dapper gent, Philip Muir. Yes.
My look, it's sort of an older person's version of a younger person's look of today. Or that's how I see it, anyway. I should think a lot of younger people look at me and think, what does he look like? But, you know, it's cool.
I'm glad you think so.
More than happy with them. That wouldn't look out of place in my local gastropub, that.
Main done, it's on to dessert. Chocolate mousse with raspberries.
And this person has done a good thing. Finishing on that note, anything chocolate, well done.
Tom starts by separating eggs.
Saved it. What a save.
And then whisks the whites.
Look at that. I'm happy with that.
It's quite heavy and too thick and creamy, then that could go a bit wrong. It needs to be light and airy.
She said light and airy, Tom.
It's looking a bit different to how it looked when I tried it the other day. I'm not giving up hope just yet. Tastes nice, though.
We'll have to take your word for that. Oh, nice cups, fella.
Not sure where these come from, actually. Kind of worrying that I've got such dainty little coffee cups, but they're in the garage. Obviously saved them for some reason. Today's the day.
The mousse goes in to chill, and it's on to the starter. Feta bruschetta.
Feta bruschetta. Sounds like an internet date, doesn't it? I'm just going to eat feta bruschetta.
I know a sister, Melinda from Tinder. Tom begins by mixing feta with fresh herbs and then chops tomatoes.
When I thought about doing my starter, I really wanted to do something fairly easy, fairly simple, something I could manage. Bruschetta seemed to tick all the boxes for that.
He'll add the topping to toasted ciabatta later on.
I was expecting something a little bit more than just cheese on toast.
Well, you're in luck. He's decided to stuff a mushroom.
This, to me, was more about not having to waste anything, and I bought one too many loaves of bread, so I thought, you know, it's a nice mix. I think, you know, a little bit of Parmesan cheese, some breadcrumbs. I think it's only going to add to the starter. That's everything done.
Food prepped, it's on with the drinks, and a final chat with the hired help.
Got a disco drink, twist on a Singapore sling, which will have a Cambridge edge to it.
More of a Cambridge sling, then. First to arrive is super stylish Philip.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Tom. Nice to meet you. Philip, come in, please. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, Phil. Here's to a good week.
To a good evening.
Up next is estate agent Sam. Careful, Sam. Careful. Wouldn't want to tread on the grass. Yes, you've made it.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you? Hi. Tom, come in. Two down, one to go.
Who will the fourth one be? I don't know.
Another girl.
Do you think?
Today.
I kind of hope it's three men versus one woman.
That's just greedy.
Bad luck, Sam. It's country girl Nicole.
Hello, I'm Sam. Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet
you.
Lovely
really?
To meet you.
Oh, I love that moustache.
Thank
oh, my goodness.
You.
Yeah, I borrowed it.
Yeah, I borrowed it from a friend.
Oh, my goodness.
It's got to go back by 10.
Coming up, follicle fixations.
Nothing sexier than a man with no hair on his head.
She is one loud lady.
And feisty footwork.
I think the whole exercise was a bit for her benefit rather than ours.
It's the first night in and around Cambridge, where host Tom Lee is hoping to impress his guests with his simple but tasty menu.
I like feta cheese, and feta and bruschetta rhyme, so it just seemed like the perfect mix for me, to be honest.
Having grilled his rhyming starter, it's done. Feta bruschetta, with a couple of stuffed mushrooms.
Hope you enjoy it, guys. Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Oh, careful.
There we go. Just a good start.
First disaster of the night.
Crunchy.
We'll just leave it there.
Shall I start by saying, you're more than welcome to pick up the bruschetta if you wish, all right?
Thank you.
No worries.
Quite hard. I put my fork and knife in and it just exploded everywhere.
Yeah, we noticed that.
I personally would have maybe done a bit of a drizzle of oil on it. I'm not going to say it was dry, it was crunchy.
Do you struggle with things in your beard?
I did find a bit of bacon in one day.
Yeah?
Which was worrying. Which was worrying because I hadn't had bacon for 2 weeks.
And it's not just beards Sam has her eyes on.
Your no hair on your head is perfect. Nothing. Nothing sexier than a man with no hair on his head. Nothing.
Steady on.
Sam, she is one loud lady. I think you'll either end up loving Sam or might be a little irritating.
Does anyone else find dreams really interesting? Have you ever looked into it to see, like, the meaning behind the dream? Yeah.
Not really, no.
I hate to admit this, but I have a few naked dreams sometimes. I've worked for my football club and I've woken up a few times and I have been in the centre of the football pitch, microphone in hand, stark naked. Don't know what that says about
That's
me.
Scary.
But yeah.
What was their response to it?
Well, I don't know. I wake up because I look around and there's 8,000 people looking at me and I've got my little wanger hanging out.
That's an image I don't need.
Tom's a really, really good guy. He's made a girl feel comfortable in a home that she's never been in before, so he's done well.
Do people think the bruschetta was too crunchy? I don't know. Yes, it dropped off Nicole's plate, but, pick it up with both hands, you know? That's kind of bruschetta's bruschetta. It should be crispy, shouldn't it?
Don't ask me.
On with the main. He reheats his lamb shanks in the microwave.
Crikey, I'm not sure they do that in Morocco.
Before getting fruity with his couscous.
I'm going to do it in some orange juice. Something a little bit different. This may backfire, but I'm sure this is the way to go with this couscous.
And the main is complete. Spicy lamb shank and orangey couscous.
Ooh, how spicy is it?
I'll let you be the judge.
Mm, okay.
Here we go. Hopefully you'll notice the slight taste to the couscous. It's cooked slightly differently. How would you normally cook couscous?
With water.
With water. See, I've done mine with orange juice.
Citrus.
Citrus.
There was no real spice to the lamb, and in fact, I was very happy about that. Lamb shank, brilliant. Couscous, not. I did expect a lot more flavour and aroma and spice.
We've all probably got little things we don't know about each other. Is there anything you might have noticed about me?
Anyone? There we are.
Oh, my gosh!
I lost these two fingers 3 years ago.
La, 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 la. I don't like things like this.
Me and a hedge cutter had a bit of an argument at work one day.
Oh, my
Nothing prepares you for having to pick your fingers up off the floor.
I was going to say, did you find your fingers?
Not only found it, I kept it as well.
No.
Oh, Where is it? It's not in your main course.
That would be a finger buffet.
Maybe should have waited till they'd finished the main, but hey, yeah. No, it was it. I got a fair reaction from it. You know, a little bit of sympathy goes a long way, I suppose.
It's not the story I would have liked to have over the dinner table.
They seemed to enjoy it. A lot of it was eaten. I've done as best as I can do, I suppose.
Main over, Tom applies the finishing touches to his dessert.
It's going to be very sickly thick chocolate, and who doesn't like that?
Here we are, chocolate mousse with raspberries in those pretty little pink cups.
Oh!
There we go.
That is death
by chocolate.
Very good. I cannot live without chocolate. I don't think a day can go by without a little bit of chocolate.
Really?
No. No, really?
What's yours then, Philip?
Mine's the other way. Mine would be cheese.
Enjoying that, are you, Sam? Taxis!
I did lick the bowl clean. The bowl was licked. It was yummy, yummy, yummy.
I don't think I would sit there licking out of a cup, but then that's Sam, isn't it?
It just didn't quite hit the mark for me. It didn't hit the spot, so for that reason I'm going to give him a 6.
Starter and main course, a little bit dry for me. Chocolate dessert, not my cup of tea. I'm going to give Tom a 6.
Tonight, I'm giving Tom a choc-tastic 6.
But not choc-tastic enough, as Tom scores an average 18. It's the second day in and around Cambridge, and the turn of green-fingered Nicole Saunders to host.
Last night, I don't think it was a winning night, simply because of the food. It was having your mates round for a beer food, maybe.
I'm actually intrigued by Nicole's night, because I can't make her out.
Nicole didn't give too much away. I would imagine she's going to be a good host, and she's probably done it a lot of times, so she will have mastered the art.
Nicole reckons she's got you sussed as well.
Consider myself quite a loud person. I was like a mouse next to Sam. It may get a bit annoying by the end of the week. We'll see.
Nicole's kicking off with her dessert. Homegrown apple and berry crumble with sheep's milk ice cream.
Who can argue with an apple crumble? It's good British food. Everyone loves British food.
I don't think I'll like it because there's no chocolate in this dessert. A dessert without chocolate, that's not a dessert.
Yes, it is. Nicole layers fruit into a baking dish before making her crumble topping, mixing flour, butter and sugar.
You have to have a little bit of muscle to get the crumble to look really like breadcrumbs.
She'll bake her crumble once her guests have arrived.
Sheep's milk ice cream. Not quite sure about that, if I'm honest.
How do you milk a sheep, by the way? Do sheep have big udders? How do you milk a sheep?
Who are you talking to?
I prefer not to use dairy anywhere in any of my cooking because I don't believe that the human body was made to consume cow's milk.
But sheep's milk is fine, I suppose.
On with her main. Baked salmon with a herby potato bake.
This dish is going to be a taste sensation, without a doubt.
She starts by topping her salmon with a herb butter and a slice of lime.
I think I might be surprised by her. I think she's likely to go the extra mile with things. So I think she'll do a little bit more than just placing it in a baking tray.
Yes, she's wrapped it in foil before placing it on a baking tray and will bake later, so it's onto the herby potatoes. Nicole mixes sweet potatoes and regular potatoes with a selection of veg, herbs and spices. And it's onto the starter.
Warm pigeon and bacon salad.
Pigeon breast salad. Wonderful. Love it. If it's cooked pink.
I think when they see pigeon on the menu, they're going to believe it was bought from a shop. I don't think they'll have any clue that it's been shot. I think the guests might fear that this is a bit too sophisticated for them.
I've never eaten pigeon in my life. Interesting.
She'll pan fry the pigeon later and will serve with bacon and salad.
I do truly believe in myself and I believe in my recipes. Let's just hope that they have their best taste buds in.
Prep done, Nicole's off to get changed.
I think it's quite a country menu, but she doesn't strike me as a country bumpkin. Is that disrespectful, that word?
What, to bumpkins?
Yeah.
I think you're all right.
I stand by my menu at the moment. If she delivers on this today, then my menu's under a little bit of pressure, but, yeah, you know, it is what it is.
Time to give them a taste of the good life. Tally-ho!
And first in, a man who tries to live the good life all the time, it's Philip.
Hello, my darling.
Hey.
How are you?
I'd have brought my Speedos if I'd known.
That's exactly why it's out of bounds, because I'm sorry I love you, but I don't want to see you in your Speedos.
Well, that's awkward.
Oh, absolutely. Your guests are very welcome.
Next to arrive, it's Tom.
I'm through to the garden.
Young man.
How are you?
Nice to see you. Yeah, nice to see you. Well?
Which just leaves Sam to complete the party.
Oh, hello, lady.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Come good. Here, come
so, guys, here's to a lovely summer farmyard evening. May we drink and be merry and behave.
Yes.
As Nicole prepares her pigeon, there appears to be a problem.
I don't like there to be blood coming out, so that's going to need another 30 seconds.
Blood gone, it's finally ready. Warm pigeon and bacon salad.
You're welcome.
Because they say pigeon is a flying rat, don't they?
Yes.
So, Nicole?
Yes.
Pigeon.
So, yes, I did shoot the pigeon. Shoot them, pluck them, cut them up, cook them.
She's a female Rambo. I'm really, really impressed by her. Really impressed. I love it. Well done her.
So, before I take another bite, when was this little bad boy shot?
Yesterday.
Oh, sorry, what?
You're shutting me up.
I don't know what you want to do.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Usually I can tell with first bite. With this, I want to try it a little bit more.
Yeah.
Let's get more
see
on
how you get on.
See how I get on.
Okay.
Salad, very good. Pigeon, don't need to ever have it again.
I love pigeon. Pigeon is one of my favourite foods. And I know how to cook it. And it was overcooked and chewy.
This starter really is as fresh as it gets. I try and use as many fresh ingredients as possible every single day. I don't know how you guys feel about that.
Absolutely. It
makes you feel a lot better about what you're eating, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That doesn't mean to say I don't binge on junk food as well.
Absolutely.
In Philip's world, you see, you can buy four pigeon's breasts for £2.99, hygienically wrapped on a polystyrene tray. So why would you go and shoot the damn thing?
I feel like I've given everyone an education in game today.
I wouldn't be too sure about that. Time to tackle your main.
Why?
Just because. And it's ready. Baked salmon with a herby potato bake.
Mmm. Salmon's very moist.
Very moist, yeah.
Isn't it? Mmm. That is a compliment.
I mean, that is a compliment.
Nothing was particularly brilliant about it.
Bit of baked salmon and some potato mush. Not dinner party food.
The main course, I think, went down a treat. But yeah, the response seems pretty good.
It's not, and it's not just the food that's the problem.
To me, a dinner party is not just about the food. Tonight, I'm a little bit bored, if I'm honest.
Lots of people comment on my very loud voice. Yeah. What do they say about you that is annoying or irritating?
Yeah, no, I don't think I have any annoying traits. Not one.
Nothing at all.
No, no one has ever said to me. But then I don't usually get invited back.
One of them, believe it or not, is being intimidating.
Snap, snap, snap. Do you know how many times I've been told that?
I think I have a lot in common with Nicole. I think I'm probably louder, more in your face and more fiery. But she's got bite, that girl. She's got bite and I like it.
Sam has shown another side to her tonight. And I feel like we've gone through a lot of the same experiences in our life and I've just done them first. So I feel like I'm kind of doing the mother hen thing and just picking her up in my...
In your...
What's the word?
I don't know.
Backdraft? What's the word?
I don't think it's that.
I think both the girls like to think they're intimidating, but I'm not intimidated by either of them.
Well, perhaps you should be, as Nicole is making her guests work for their dessert.
I
So you do.
Be gentle.
Jab, cross, and you're going to turn the pad for me.
Nicole told us she does kickboxing. I'm not surprised by anything she says now. I think the whole exercise was a bit for her benefit rather than ours. I'm not sure how into it we all were.
Philip and I had more fun laughing in the background, and I really enjoyed Philip being really, really annoyed at it. He didn't want to do it at all.
Right.
Rabbit bump. Second rabbit bump there.
Hook round.
No way would I take my dinner guests outside and expect them to start boxing.
Did I feel a bit butch?
With her night on the ropes, her last chance to impress is with dessert. Homegrown apple and berry crumble with sheep's milk ice cream.
I liken myself to The Good Life. I loved that programme growing up, and that's how I like to think of myself now. But it would be interesting to see what you guys kind of consider yourselves as. What TV programme would you liken yourself to?
I've got a whole list for you, then.
Father Christmas.
Father Christmas, Uncle Albert, Captain Hook.
Who could I be?
I think Mrs. Four. Brown from Mrs. Brown's Boys.
Yes! Thank
but
you!
She's loud and common.
Oh, taxis!
Common?
Dessert was very, as I expected. A nursery dessert.
She tried her best, she really, really did, but it's just not what I'm used to and not something that I need to do again in a hurry.
Nicole put on a good show for everyone, but it really wasn't my cup of tea. I've just felt things could have been a bit quicker, a bit more exciting, a few more laughs.
I'm scoring Nicole a 5.
I'm going to give Nicole a 6.
Tonight, I'm going to give Nicole a 6.
Which doesn't make Nicole cream of the crop. She scores just 17, putting her out of the running. Not that she has any idea.
We'll see how the rest of the week goes, but I'm feeling pretty confident right now.
Coming up, massive mains.
This was made for a giant.
And super-sized shorts.
Yes. Hang about.
Oh, my God!
With that beard and this waist, I need it cleared up at Christmas, wouldn't I? You know you'll make me want
a shot. It's day 3 in and around Cambridge, and the turn of estate agent Sam Friend to host.
The food this week so far, it's all been edible, but there's nothing I can write home about. I don't think that my food is necessarily the best, but I'd like to think I'm a good host. I do things to please people, so I'm hoping that I'll do the right things tonight to please my guests.
The last night being a bit disappointingly quiet, I'm looking forward to having it tonight with Sam.
I'm not expecting fine dining.
Tonight, my menu is home-cooked food, so it's made with love.
Oh, that's lovely. And she begins with her starter, sweet potato and chorizo soup.
Soup is ridiculously easy. My 10-year-old son makes me soup by himself, so, yeah, it's not hard, is it?
Not really a fan of chorizo at all. My brother loves the stuff, and he's always banging on about it.
Jamie's not coming tonight.
I hope they'll see that I've made an effort by getting red wine, getting white wine, getting Prosecco, even got a bottle of champagne as well.
You never. Champagne?
Not that I know how to open it. I don't know how to pop it. I don't think I've ever done it before.
I'm sure Philip's popped a few in his time. Sam mixes red onion, sweet potato and garlic, then roasts.
I think the starter is a punchy starter, and it will be nice.
Okay. Sam blends the roasted veg with stock, and the soup will be reheated later.
Just needs a bit of chorizo, and that'll be brilliant. Good chorizo.
On with her dessert. Brownie, blondie and fruity.
Brownie is just a chocolate brownie. A blondie is white chocolate and raspberry brownie.
I would have bet 100% that it was going to be chocolate. She's a girl after my own heart in that respect.
I think as a chocolate connoisseur as she is, this is going to be good. You finish a menu with chocolate, that's the only way to finish a menu.
If you say so. Sam starts with her blondie. She whisks together eggs and sugar before adding melted butter, raspberries and white chocolate.
Tastes very, very sugary.
No.
I don't know if that's what it should taste like.
Why are you whispering? She sieves in flour and dollops the mixture onto a baking tray.
A fair amount of effort I'm putting in, yes. Hopefully they will appreciate it.
She repeats the recipe for the brownie using dark chocolate.
Nice.
All right, leave some for your guests. Both desserts are then baked and will be served later with a strawberry. That just leaves her main, chicken Wellington with Dauphinoise potatoes.
Boring.
I think this is more dinner party food. Because I'm trying to remember what I had the other two nights.
Keep up, Philip. Sam starts with the Wellington.
I have seen chefs use shop-bought puff pastry, so this chef is using shop-bought puff pastry too.
Sam stuffs her chicken with a bacon, mushroom and cream cheese filling before wrapping it in the shop-bought pastry. She'll bake them later, and so moves on to the Dauphinoise. Having boiled potatoes in cream...
Tastes calorie-free. Tastes like I'll lose weight eating this. Definitely.
She adds cheese.
This is going to be quite cheesy, I think.
Yes, cheese does that. Food done, there's just time for a last minute...
Get down and I... Ooh!
Whatever that is, before she's off to get changed.
I'm ready, contracts have exchanged, and it's time for completion.
Let's hope you're not gazumped. And Tom's the first to let himself into Sam's back garden.
Grass needs cutting.
Fabulous Philip is next to arrive.
Tradesman's entrance, around the back door.
Run.
Could have cut the grass.
Oh, is everyone going to say this as they walk in?
Well, take it as a hint. And finally, it's last night's host, Nicole. Don't mention the grass.
Oh, we're finally complete. Can we have a cheers, please? Cheers!
With Sam busy in the kitchen, the guests are having a nosy.
No, I saw it when I walked in and I thought, oh, God, she's got a man cage and he's escaped.
That's a little bit scary. You know. It doesn't look finished and it doesn't look very well done. I think that she's done this herself. I think she's having a go at something.
I think it's taking that shabby sheep to the garden.
I still have no idea what she's trying to do, to be brutally honest.
Me neither.
Really happy with my soup, actually. Yeah, it's turning out so far so good.
So glad to hear it. And here it is, sweet potato and chorizo soup.
Do you think this is like Spanish baby food?
Yeah, it's a little bit, actually. That's very true, very true. You mean it in the nicest possible way, I'm guessing.
Yeah. I'm just thinking, because it's quite thick, isn't it? Then?
Yeah.
Philip absolutely killed her with the baby food comment. I don't think any of us disagreed either.
How are you all enjoying it?
I'm not a massive chorizo fan.
You're not?
His brother is.
Gosh.
The soup itself is lovely, but
just don't
please
eat the
don't
lumps.
Be offended if I'm not going to eat
don't eat the
all
lumps.
The chorizo because it's...
Flavour, beautiful. However, I didn't get a chance to savour the flavour because there was too much spice and I was holding back the choking.
I tell you when I have soup, when I'm ill, tin of tomato soup, I always know... if I'm ill, because I always fancy tinned tomato soup, which is hideous stuff.
With the soup far from super, Philip wants to know what lurks at the bottom of the garden.
Did something escape?
When I moved here, I always, always, always wanted chickens. I got it made. I didn't make it myself.
You know, I actually thought you'd done that yourself.
Because it's a bodge job, you mean?
Yeah. No offence, but I kind of looked at it and thought, oh, bless Sam, because I know what she's like. She'll be wanting to be like, yeah, girl power.
Yes.
I'm going to do this myself.
Yeah.
It will turn it wrong, but she'd still try.
Yeah.
You know what I thought?
Did it with our spirit level.
Yes. Have you seen an item of this room that's done without a spirit level?
Luckily, they're not marking your DIY skills, Sam.
What's DIY in your house?
DIY in my house is, I would class that as a lonely night.
Moving on!
I'm glad Philip and Nicole are the two sat next to each other this evening. They are bouncing off each other. It's like a carry-on movie sometimes downstairs.
It's been a jokey and fun start to the night, so let's hope that it just becomes more and more fun as the night goes on.
Yes! On with the main. Looks like more baby food.
This is a home meal. So it's not going to be Michelin star looking. Let's just hope that it's Michelin star tasting.
Sam's main is ready. Chicken Wellington with Dauphinoise potatoes.
And here it is.
Aha.
Wow.
I thought Tom's portions were big. This was made for a giant.
Did you make the pastry?
What do you think?
I haven't tried it yet.
Try it and then tell me.
I think it's fresh from the supermarket.
Bingo. Have you guys ever made pastry?
I always make my own pastry, I have to admit.
Even puff pastry?
Anything.
Amazing.
All made from fresh.
Very disappointed that she didn't make it herself, because it's really easy to make your own pastry. It's so easy.
And you need to learn, I do. I tried, is it choux pastry? Choux pastry, the profiterole pastry. Mm. That one, I've tried that one. I can do that one, but that one's a little bit different.
You do a choux, but not a Wellington.
No need to put the boot in.
Chicken cooked beautifully. The mushrooms with bacon were tasty. The pastry was great. Shop-bought pastry, but, you know, most people do use that. But it could have been half the size.
The chicken was nice, the veg was nice. I was actually really impressed with it.
My perfect night is come home from work, bra is off, pyjamas are on.
I'm exactly the same.
I'm on the sofa. You take your bra off? Yeah. You shouldn't. They will hang low if you let them go.
Fair play to Sam with her bra off at clock revelation. I'll just make sure I'm not here for that, eh?
What do you guys do in a perfect night?
A four-pack of beer and a game of football.
OK.
From the bottom of my heart, it would be a four-pack and a game of football. But, to be honest, I don't even know what a four-pack is. Is that a case of champagne?
Not watched a football match in my life, so I don't think I'm going to start now, am I?
Bit more my sort of night this evening. It's a bit livelier, and certainly the conversation's flowing a little bit easier than last night.
With the Wellington and Sam's hosting mostly impressing, it's now down to the dessert.
This is my best course, yes.
Oh, fingers, Sam. She licks her fingers a few more times, and the brownie is served.
Ooh, gooey.
Brownie, blondie and fruity.
Here we are, here we are.
This is perfect. Love this.
Good.
Very chocolatey.
You're not a chocolate fan, are you?
No.
No. It's going to be too sickly for you. If you were to sell yourself as a house.
I know what I am as a house. I'm a Victorian wreck in need of total renovation.
What would I be?
You'd be a masonette, 1960s.
She's definitely not a flat.
No.
Taxes!
Not sure if it was a brownie or what it was, really, but it was chocolate, so it was more than enough for me. It was lovely.
I feel like Sam could learn that less is more in every area of her life. Especially when it comes to her cooking.
The chocolate thing was just chocolate, wasn't it? I was going to say disgusting, but that's not very nice, is it?
Not really.
It has, for me, been the best night so far, yes. I think that my food turned out well.
Let's see if your guests agree.
Compared to last night, I've had a much better night tonight. Not everything was right, but the food I did like was gorgeous. So for that reason, I'm going to give Sam an 8.
I'm going to give Sam a 6.
And I'm giving Sam a 6.
Which leaves Sam with a total of 20 points and puts her in first place with one night to go. It's the final night of the week and the turn of retired hairdresser Philip Muir, who has a classier evening planned.
I feel the food that I've eaten this week is the sort of food I would come home and maybe sort of knock up for myself. There wasn't a drizzle or a scatter.
I feel like I'm going to enjoy Philip's night more just because it's Philip and I love him. I'm very much looking forward to it.
So Philip gets on with it, starting with his main. Pulled pork with crushed potatoes and apple sauce.
Good man, Philip. Love the sound of that. That's my sort of dinner.
I want the pork to be seriously delicious.
Philip slow cooks his marinated pork shoulder and will pull the meat later on. He'll serve the pork with two sauces, a barbecue and an apple sauce.
When my guests see my menu, they're going to go, I knew it was going to be good. I knew it was going to be good. And they're going to go, I don't like pulled pork. I don't like apple sauce.
I know lots of people like apple with pork. No, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it.
When you're a child, and you had a cooking apple, it was like, oh my God, that's so sour. But as an adult, you think, oh, that's lovely, it's all tart. And we do love a tart.
On with the starter, salmon timbale.
What's that when it's at home? Timbale, that's a drum, isn't it? That's an instrument.
Yes, it's a drum of salmon, Nicole.
Salmon timbale, timbale, salmon. I don't know what that is.
It's a fish.
Sounds posh, though.
Well, a timbale, it's anything that you're going to put into a ramekin and then turn out.
Thank you, Philip. He flakes pan-fried salmon into a bowl with spring onions before adding a boiled egg and breadcrumbs.
Oh, my God, there's a cockroach.
Yay!
They're bug bags.
Oh, you joker. In go cream cheese and mustard powder before he fills the smoked salmon-lined ramekins.
It will be as beautiful as me.
They'll be set aside, ready to serve later with a little caviar, which leaves Philip's dessert. Baked figs with mascarpone and chocolate-dipped strawberries.
Philip this week hasn't really warmed to any of the desserts. I'm not sure how he's going to quite warm to his own.
Roasted fruit, baked fruit, wonderful with honey and nuts. And I would rather have that sort of dessert rather than lashings of cream and lashings of chocolate.
Philip adds French butter, honey, thyme and pudding wine to his figs.
I think they are the making of a winning dessert, if it all goes to plan.
Figs. No. I don't like them. I don't like them. And that's not going to be enough chocolate on a strawberry, is it?
Before I knew them, I said I was going to do chocolate strawberries, because I think they're quite nice things to nibble on, aren't they? They're just fun.
Oh, chocolate-dipped strawberries. I can just see him feeding Sam over the table. Oh, darling.
Yes, I'm picturing that myself. He dips strawberries and biscuits.
I mean, it is simple, but sometimes the simplest of things
are the best.
They're sorted, coated in chocolate, but I'm going to pop them in the fridge to set, and they will be fabulous.
All that's left to do is make himself look fabulous.
OK, I'm now ready, and I think this is the face of a winner.
A very hairy winner. First up and dressed like one of the air vents, it's Sam.
Oh! Hello!
Sorry!
Hello.
Sorry, was it wet?
You've got a wet beard.
It's soaked in champagne, don't you know? Next up, it's Tom.
Tom.
Darling.
My man. Hey, darling, you've changed it.
Good.
Come in.
I bought a gift. I bought a bottle every time this week, but for you, something different. Your very own. I thought it was very you.
I love it. What is it?
And finally, it's Nicole.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To the last night.
Yeah.
Last night.
Coming up, a stylish starter.
They are visual.
A perfect pud.
This, for me, is the best dessert of the whole week.
And someone bags a gram.
And the results.
It's the final night, and retired hairdresser Philip Muir is hoping to win the grand with an evening of elegance.
Should we have a look under his bed?
Should we have a little rummage, or...?
Yeah, go for it.
You do it.
They don't look like his style.
Hang about.
Oh my God.
Hang on a minute.
To be honest with you, I can imagine Philip being this size. Because he's just so jolly.
Yeah.
I just imagine him being like a roly-poly, jolly
fellow.
I'll tell you what, with that beard and this waistline, he'd have cleared up at Christmas, wouldn't he?
Yes, he would. Yes, he would.
Back in the kitchen, Philip is feeling competitive.
I do want to win. I don't know why, but all of a sudden, I want to win. They're almost like a painting, aren't they? They're so fabulous. I mean, they are visual.
If you say so. Here it is, salmon timbale with caviar.
It looked beautiful. I didn't want to touch it. And the finishing touch of caviar. Gorgeous.
Not enjoying your timbale.
I'm sorry, I don't like it.
Did you eat the salmon the other night?
Yeah.
What's it about tonight then?
I don't know.
I think it's lovely, mate.
I don't know.
Thank you.
Sam's a bit quiet tonight. She seemed to like the salmon the other night but didn't eat it tonight. I'm not sure what that means.
I think I've got more of a bog standard palate, I suppose. I don't spend big money on big expensive things like caviar, and I'm glad I don't, because I don't like them.
We were having a little rummage around your bedroom earlier on.
Were you?
Yes.
A rummage?
Yeah. I found a pair of shorts. I think you can call them shorts.
They used to be a little tight on me, if I know the ones you're talking about.
No, they didn't. Wow. So how long ago was that you could fit into those?
Really?
What did you do? Did you starve yourself?
No, I went to a slimming club.
Wow. And how much did you lose, if you don't mind me
six
asking?
Six stone. You know, because it really is just healthy eating. But healthy eating is fabulous, but God, it can be boring.
Yes.
Can't it?
Is that why
you're
going to
think, all I want is salmon timbal.
He's done fantastically losing that weight. He's happy now. I think he needs to do a better job of maintaining, but as long as he's happy, I'm happy.
Well, I'm happy, you're happy.
Honestly, I've got photos of me running in the sports day when I was five with these biceps. I just...
You have to keep that up there, because they'll end up bingo wings.
Yeah, I know, I've got bingo wings as well.
Yeah, especially if your implants end up down there. Oh, my God,
Nicole showed us her guns earlier on. Oh, very impressive, but I must say I did like the bingo wings a little bit more.
On with the main. Philip pulls his pork before moving on to his spuds.
And now the crushing. They're now crushed.
I'd check if I were you.
No, not crushed enough.
Any better?
No, they're not crushed enough.
Use a spoon, that's it. Philip's main is complete. Pulled pork and crushed potatoes with an apple and barbecue sauce.
Oh, that's all I have to say.
I think you and I would be running away together.
It's lovely. I'm just not 100% on the apple. But that's just me, I think.
Oh, bingo.
But it's lovely, mate. Yeah. You've done well.
There was quite a lot of flavours going on. The barbecue sauce had obviously taken a lot of time to make itself. I thought that was great.
I didn't like the main course either. There was apple on my pork and I don't like apple.
Oh, apple, you poor thing. As the week draws to an end, the group are revealing what they first thought of each other.
Philip didn't even have to open his mouth for me to know that I was going to find him fabulous.
Aww. Aww.
Sam, I was taken aback by the volume.
But, you're right, Tom.
But literally, within milliseconds, it made me intrigued.
And I just thought, she is going to be so annoying. She's actually fabulous.
Lovely.
I have to kind of echo what everyone said, Sam. Yeah. I hate to break it to you, but I was dreading it, to be honest. But I think we've got a lovely... Your night last night was fantastic. And you, you'd eat me alive, you would.
We will all be meeting up, whether it be for dinner or drinks or party or alternative fun. We will be meeting up again.
Alternative fun, you say?
Don't know where that came from, sorry.
After a mixed reception for the main, Philip's not holding out much hope for his figs.
Do you know, I just have a very strong feeling that Sam's going to push it round the playing game. I don't like that. And if she don't like it...
She can ruddy well clear off home.
Precisely. I have no confidence with this, but I have a backup plan, and it's called chocolate.
Clever. Here it is, baked figs with mascarpone and chocolate sauce just for Sam.
No nuts, or is it just the way you're
Thank
sitting?
Thank you. Oh, this for me is the best dessert of the whole week.
I think the dessert was completely Nicole's cup of tea. Just wasn't mine.
That's it. Everything's better with a bit
All
of chocolate.
Done.
Tonight has been as expected. This competition, as far as I'm concerned, is between me and Philip.
I wouldn't be too sure about that, as it's Sam that Philip needs to beat to bag the grand.
Philip's put a great amount of effort into tonight, which I really appreciate, but there was elements of the meal that didn't work for me. So for that reason, I give Philip a 7.
It was a great night, but I'm still hungry, so I'm giving Philip a 5.
I love the starter. I love the dessert. The main was so-so, but I love Philip. So that's why he has to get...
Whoa! Hold it there! It's our host's job to reveal the results.
Here we go! And the results. Fourth place is Nicole. Oh! And third place is Tom. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'll take that.
And in second place... No! I don't believe it. It's not you. It's not me. It's joints!
Nicole scored Philip an 8, meaning a tie for first place.
Zoe!
Zoe! And I thought I was better than you!
I
think I was surrounded by guests who don't appreciate natural food.
I didn't come last, that's all I can ask. If you want to appear on Come Dine With Me, go to the Channel 4 website.
It hasn't even sunk in properly yet, but I am so, so happy.
I've won £500, how wonderful.
It's the Champion of Champions Come Down next week, starting Monday at 5 o'clock. And tonight, from not even one tattoo to the whole body covered, body shockers, nips, tucks and tats at 10 o'clock. And next, if you've seen The Revenant, you'll have sympathy for a grisly Homer in The Simpsons. You wanna look pretty though in my video. Oh, dirty on the hat and I let you...